Hello and welcome to City Edition, the City of Bend's video news magazine. I'm Justin Finestone. Like many cities across the country, Bend is faced with increasing costs related to our water supply. To deal with new federal regulatory requirements and aging infrastructure, the City Council has made long-term decisions to ensure all of us a clean, safe, and reliable supply of water.
After 30 years of study and half a dozen engineering firms giving us their recommendations, the City Council has decided to go forward on the water project to keep our surface water and rebuild the pipe, put in a filtration system. It is a huge investment right from the start, but long term, it's the best for the water ratepayers in our city.
The council's gone through a very involved fact-finding process in reaching this important decision. There have been many hours of meetings, in official city council meetings, in which the council's heard from a wide array of folks about what they think about what we should do.
The decision between surface water and groundwater has been studied by the City of Bend for 30 years. The first study was done in 1980, where a very in-depth analysis was done on the reinvestment in the Bridge Creek surface water supply. And the conclusion of that study was to make that reinvestment in the surface water supply, and in addition to consider adding hydroelectric power to the project.
This surface water project is going to be a huge investment for the City of Bend, and one that will benefit our community for decades and maybe even a century to come. It's an important investment to ensure that we have the water that we need to make sure that people in Bend are safe, they have a safe, clean, good supply of water like we do right now, and that we have the water available to attract the kind of employers we need in this city.
In the short term, the critics are right. It is less expensive to drill more wells rather than to do this surface water project. But a city needs to think for their infrastructure in a longer term frame. We need to be looking at 20, 50, and even 100 years out. And long term, this is a much less expensive way to go.
Since 1980, there's been a half dozen engineering firms that have looked at the surface water versus groundwater option. The conclusion by the engineering firms, both the 1980 report as well as all the recent analysis that has been done, is the same. They've all made the same suggestion to make the reinvestment in the surface water supply. This is primarily for two reasons. One, that the current supply offers us a dual source system. This is considered highly valuable in terms of water supply in the engineering world. And then the second reason is because of the fact that it's a gravity-fed system. A gravity-fed system by nature does not require power, and therefore the long-term power savings of this reinvestment are significant.
The new surface water system will consist of a single pipe that will be located in Skyliners Road, and a new water treatment facility, a membrane treatment facility located at Outback. The treatment facility is required because of a federal mandate to filter our water or address the cryptosporidium that can be found in surface water systems. The existing surface water pipelines have no flow control on them. That means that they take water from Bridge Creek 24/7. The new system will have flow control at the Outback site, which is at the bottom of the 10 miles of pipeline, which will allow us to, when we aren't using the water or taking it into town for beneficial use, we'll be able to turn down those valves or turn off those valves and put that water back in the creek up at the Bridge Creek intake facility and have all that water in the Tumalo Creek.
Another important difference of the surface water improvement project will be the elimination of the overland bypass flow system that's in place now at the Outback site. Currently, and since the late 1920s, there is a overland canal and conduit system that takes any flows that can't be taken into town for beneficial use down to the Tumalo drainage. Also, as part of the surface water improvement project, there will be a bypass pipe constructed that will be sized to take all of the surface water if at any given time there would be a need to instantaneously bypass those flows, and those flows would be taken in that new pipeline down to the Tumalo drainage.
One of the benefits of continuing to use the city's historic surface water source up at Bridge Creek is that we have very solid water rights for that water. The water that we get from that creek is clean, cold, some of the best water for any municipality in the state, and we've got a right to it.
Our water rights for our surface water are certificated and unchallengeable. That's the gold standard for water rights, and we have a water right that is basically risk-free.
Those water rights have been perfected to the amount of 27 cubic feet per second, although we are permitted to take a total of 36 cubic feet per second from the system.
For City of Bend, surface water is the best answer because it gives us a dual source system. We have the opportunity not only to get our water from a great aquifer, we also have the Bridge Creek surface water system that provides a gravity system and gives us the duality and the protection of having two sources to choose from if one would for some reason become contaminated.
Well, this is the biggest decision that I've made in my 2 years on City Council, and it's certainly one that I think Council has not come to easily. There have been numerous public meetings, there's been review of many, many reams of documents in support of this decision, and it's not an easy decision. None of us would say it's an easy decision, but it's one that it's our job to make, and I think we've done the deliberative process to make the right decision.